set the stage for us, so to speak.
Well, of course, Henry VIII has found a new girlfriend, Jane Seymour. Anna is imprisoned. There are some wonderful lines that Bolena says. She hears the celebration going on. I mean, all this is non-historical, to say that. I mean, it's totally inaccurate. But this, I had a favorite line that I really wrestled with. And what she says is, this mockery lacks only the blood of Bolena, and it will be shed. I mean, Donizetti was really quite he took on a lot of challenges. There's a wonderful line in Devereux where she says, Essex, when she learns he's betrayed her, "It would have been better for you to incite the wrath of the gods than to have incited the wrath of the daughter of the terrible Henry VIII. I mean, that's a cannon shot.
Yes.
And that he was able to write music for it is incredible. And the same thing in this finale of Bolena. When I was working on this with Roland, when it came to the final cabaletta, I said to him, we've got to, I mean, the woman in history supposedly was taking morphine at this point to calm herself. I mean, she had become addicted to drugs. And I said, we've got to be able to show in some way towards the end of it the hysteria of the woman and not let it just be an embellished second verse to a cabaletta. And he's the one that put in, I think there are like 9 consecutive trills. I don't even know how, they're all ascending. And you
trills,
get the hysteria of the woman in it. And that to me was a kind of brilliant touch, because while it was a kind of show-offy, you know, here's 9 trills for you or something, it was an ornament that dramatically enhanced the moment for me, even as performing it. It got me to such a peak that when I reached the final and top trill, I was in a kind of abandon. So it's a very difficult mad scene. If you don't pace yourself and you shoot the works in the first 2/3 of the opera, you have 3 incredibly different and difficult arias
right.
to
it's
finish
really
the piece.
It's really a chain
with.
Of arias,
yes.
And it begins in a nostalgic fashion and a melancholy fashion, and it ends in fireworks.
And the breath control that you need for it is a killer. And I, never being an intellectual performer, but always kind of shooting from the hip, lots of times found the scene with Jane Seymour just so emotionally charged that when I did the mad scene with the Zubin Mehta and the L.A. Orchestra, it just in concert, I said to him, Zubin, give, you know, let me pace it because it's a killer. And Zubin, I mean, that was, I threw the glove down to Zubin. And he went at this mad scene, and I thought, I am never going to make that high E-flat at the end. Never. There's just no way. I did, of course, and there was a poster that was used for years of Zubin and my hand high up in the air on the high E-flat. I wish they had taken the picture 3 seconds after the E-flat to show the look of triumph on my face. A lot of fun.
Well, let's hear it all.